It's been grounded for more than three decades, but now one of the world's largest icebergs has broken free and it's on the move. A23A, as it's known to its friends, is about 4,000 square kilometers in size. That's about three quarters the size of Prince Edward Island. Now, for more on this, joining us is Dan Riskin, our CTV science and technology expert. Dan, thank you as always for joining us and talking. That's a lot of drinks you could make with the ice in that.
You can do a lot with it, but I think most people are just sort of focused on not running into it and also trying to understand what the consequences will be if something that big hits a mass of land. Because you can imagine if you're a coastal animal, having a giant island of ice come up and hit you, it would sit there for quite a while. I mean, so this thing broke off of Antarctica in 1986. And just to drive home how long ago that was, there was a Soviet research station on it when it broke off, and they had to go fly in and get all the pieces out of there and move them back to Antarctica as this thing drifted away. And it started moving out into the sea, and then it got stuck. It was thick enough that it touched the bottom, and it sort of got stuck where it was. And it's been sitting there since 1986, slowly shrinking, but for the most part just staying put. And now they've noticed, looking at satellite imagery, and you know, again, there aren't people sitting there going, oh, look, it's moving again. It's looking at successive images from satellites. We were like, wait a second, this thing started moving again in about 2020. And so now they realize this thing is adrift, and it's moving out away from Antarctica into the sea that goes around Antarctica. And ultimately, that's going to take it drifting northward. And nobody really knows exactly where it's going to end up.
And how, I mean, we know this size-wise, square kilometers, how high is this thing sitting out of the water? And then it's 90% is below the water, right?
Right, right. Well, this one's going to be a little bit of a different shape from the sort of the typical one, because the water's just not deep enough for how big this thing is. But just to give you a sense of how tall this thing sticks up out of the water, 400 meters. So if you've spent any time in Toronto and you've ever seen the CN Tower, this isn't taller than the CN Tower, but it is taller than the observation deck of the CN Tower. So that's how high up you are. If you're standing on this thing looking down at the water, that's how high up out of the water you are. And so this thing obviously is enormous. And you know, normally when we talk about icebergs breaking away and floating, we talk about climate change. This one doesn't seem to be a story about climate change. This is something that broke off in the 80s before climate change really had the kinds of effects that it's having now. And it drifted out. And the fact that it's melted down to a size where it sort of picked up and started drifting again seems to be just sort of in keeping with what icebergs do in their normal evolution. So this isn't sort of like this doomsday, oh, we heated up Antarctica and broke that iceberg off and now it's drifting out. And right now, by the way, it is the largest iceberg on the planet adrift at this moment. There have been bigger ones in the past, but they've all broken into smaller pieces. This one is still very, very massive. That's not to say climate change isn't real and that climate change isn't causing other icebergs, but this one is just sort of an old school Soviet era iceberg that's finally making its way out into the sea after getting stuck for three decades on its way there.
Okay, I'm still obsessing on the number. So is it 90% of the iceberg is below the surface? So that means this thing's like 4,000 meters tall in total?
Well, I don't know exactly what the dimensions are for this one. I think typically when you see one that's sort of like a pillar sticking up out of the water, like you might see off of Newfoundland or something like that, then you've got more of the ice that's got to hold it, support that weight underneath. With this one, it's an ice shelf that sort of broke off. And so it's going to be more of a hockey puck shaped thing. But I don't exactly know. In terms of mass, you would expect 90% to be below, but I'm not exactly sure what the dimensions are below water versus above water.
Do they know like where it might go with the currents, and what are there concerns or dangers for shipping or anything like that?
Well, this thing's so big that it's less of a danger for shipping because everybody can see where it is. It's not gonna surprise you. It's the smaller ones that can sometimes get you. And actually, there's an interesting story that's come out just recently from artificial intelligence where in the past, everybody's just sort of looked at these images of the sea and tried to pick out which ones are icebergs and which ones are just clouds or other things, and then circled them by hand. And now we've got artificial intelligence that can do that about 10,000 times faster than people were doing it. So we're improving our tools for detecting icebergs. And as this thing starts to break apart, that's going to be very important in this place. But the big issue with this one is as it comes up into South America or maybe into one of the other islands that occurs in the South Atlantic, and there's some small islands there with lots of shorebirds or penguins and other kinds of animals that live on them. If this thing comes up against the shore, it's going to completely change the ecology of that shoreline. And so a lot of questions about what will happen. But of course, this is, you know, ice bumping up against the land. That's kind of the name of the game down south. And so it's going to be very interesting from a biological standpoint to see what happens in the way the organisms and the way the ecosystems respond to this giant iceberg afloat in the sea.
And before we go, any idea how long this could be floating around before it finally breaks up into little ice cubes?
I haven't seen an estimate online, but the fact that it just sat there for 3 decades, sort of, you know, while everything was going on around it, I guess it'll depend where it ends up and how warm it is where it ends up. But I think that this is not going anywhere anytime soon, although as it breaks up, that will speed things up. But as long as it's one big massive berg like this, it can only melt around the sides, really. So you're going to see it. You're going to see it holding its own for decades, I'm sure.
Oh, very fascinating. All right, Dan, thank you very much. Always appreciate it.